Primrose Lane. Life's a family on Primrose Lane. Just a family on Primrose Lane.
Just a minute. Chad is for you. It's Ray.
Yeah. What's up? Just a minute. Honey, you need the car today?
Well, if it's convenient, I really do.
Can you drop me?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll be there as fast as I can. Pawn shop robbery this morning. Meeting the pawnbroker to look at some mug shots.
And then you're going to have to go out and look for the mugs.
Right. I, Ray, and the police department. Honey, relax, will you? Showing a victim mugshots is routine, you know that. 1,001, the pawnbroker won't recognize anybody out of a nice quiet day at the office.
I know, but it's just that I...
Sure, but it goes with the job.
Mom, may I borrow one of Dad's ties for a headband? Tammy's going to have the top down.
Oh, I think so. Let's see, take the blue one on the far left.
You mean this old frayed thing? Looks like a rummage sale reject. If I take this one, maybe you can get Dad to buy a new one.
Now, tell Tammy to drive carefully. The freeway will be jammed.
Slow lane all the way.
Okay. Bye-bye, dear.
Dad, I'm leaving.
Why so early? Can't we have breakfast together?
Sorry. I have a bio lab class at 8 o'clock, and it takes a good 15 minutes to find a parking spot. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Some detective never even noticed his tie.
Darling, you need a new blue tie for Ray's anniversary party tomorrow night.
I got a blue one on my rack.
That old relic is on its way down the freeway.
You mean that frayed thing around Cindy's head?
That frayed thing is right. Now you go out and buy a new one. Navy blue. It'll go good with your new suit.
Okay.
All right. Don't forget.
Right. Solid blue.
No. Navy blue.
Morning, Ed.
Morning, Chad.
Morning, Francis.
Good morning, Chad.
Chad, is it just my family, or is your family getting uptight these days, too?
Mine and everybody's. This whole thing of open season on policemen. Sullivan and Craig ambushed yesterday, walking across the street.
You know, if I hear off the pigs just once more, I'm gonna blow my top. My four-year-old kid this morning.
I know. I had a routine call from Ray. Betty wouldn't have given it a second thought. All of a sudden, big deal. Recognize anybody?
No, no luck so far. I'm Mr. Womrath. This is my partner, Sergeant Smith.
How are you? You always open up so early?
No, just two mornings a week to catch the early business. Some clients like to sneak into a pawn shop when nobody's around.
Two suspects came in almost on top of him when he opened up. They just about cleaned him out. Cash, jewelry, guns.
Guns.
I put out a description of the jewelry, serial numbers of the guns. Four Smith and Wesson 38s.
Not to mention $1,163 in cash.
What'd they look like?
Well, one of them was dark-haired, bushy, over 6 foot, sideburns.
What about the other one?
The guy who hit me was a blonde, around 40.
That could fit half the men in our files.
Yeah, but I'd know him anywhere.
Why, any marks, scars?
He had a busted eyebrow like he used to be a fighter.
Narrows it down.
and a scar right there, like maybe a knife fight.
You got something?
Maybe. It's a lead, anyway. Anything else? Anything unusual about his breathing?
Breathing. Asthma.
Charlie Pasmonic.
Sounds like it. Is he out of San Quentin?
Yeah, he's been out about a month.
That's the guy. You see the slash?
You're lucky he only hit you, Mr. Womrath. Ray, I know an old woman in the pawn shop neighborhood might just have a lead for us.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, dear.
Where's Dad?
Oh, I dropped him off at headquarters.
I thought we were all supposed to be here for breakfast.
Yep, that's the idea, but sometimes we don't make it.
What a rat race. Rush, rush, rush. Work, work, work.
And for what? So we can eat, 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 among other things.
I'm serious, Mom. Why don't we drop out? Go to Alaska, pioneer country, and live close to the soil.
I don't want to live in Alaska. It's 40 degrees below zero and full of icebergs.
Okay. I'll settle for the Florida Everglades.
Alligators and polluted waters. Miss Anderson says it's up to the new generation to keep planet Earth from becoming a great big giant garbage dump.
Sure. She expects your generation to clean up the mess her generation made.
Uh-oh, that makes me guilty, too. Miss Anderson and I are the same age.
Huh. You look 20 years younger.
Mom, is it okay if me and the guys collect empty bottles this afternoon? The money goes to buying books for the school library. Please, Mom, it's for what they call ecology.
Okay, it's a very worthwhile project. Everybody should do what they can. Bob, sit down and eat your breakfast. Come on.
No time, Mom. I gotta go. Rush, rush, rush.
That's it for me, too. Bye, Mom.
Goodbye, Brian.
You know I'm Francie?
Like the inside of my cash box. Charlie Pasmonic takes the racing form from me every morning since he got out of Quentin.
Anybody around with him?
Last few weeks, a guy calls Gus. Crazy guy from Des Moines. Buys a lot of dirty magazines.
Husky guy, just over 6 feet. Thick black hair, long sideburns.
Right. Wears a lot of cologne.
Where do they live?
Gotta be close by. They don't use wheels. What is it, a heist?
This morning, pawn shop, 3 blocks from here.
What'd they get?
Rings, watches, handguns.
Rings and watches, they could fence most any place. The handguns, I'd say, Artie Ritter runs a family bicycle shop not far from here on Normandy over near Curzon.
Thanks, if it pays off, you get paid off.
Yeah.
See ya.
Uh-huh.
Officers, you Arthur Ritter?
Yeah. What can I do for you?
Recognize him?
But that's a mugshot. Why should I recognize it?
It's Charlie Pasmonic. You were in San Quentin the same time he was.
Well, that's like saying I was in the same army. Q's a big place. I'm clean. Have been for over 4 years.
Well, if you're all that clean, you won't mind us looking around a little.
You got a search warrant?
No. Want us to get one?
No. I got nothing to hide. Look around all you want. All right, Ritter, stand by your wife. Hey, take it easy, will you? Break anything, you'll pay for it.
Stay back, Ritter. Stay back.
Yeah.
Smith & Wesson 38s. You're under arrest, Ritter. You too, Miss Ritter. You get your hands behind your back.
Let them rave, honey. No law against having guns.
There's for next convict.
Artie, I told you this would happen.
Look, shut up.
The law requires that I warn you of your rights. You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent, anything you say can and will be held against you in a court of law. You have the right to speak with an attorney. Have an attorney present during questioning. If you so desire and cannot afford it, an attorney will be provided for you without charge before questioning. Is that understood?
Yes.
More here.
Must be a dozen guns.
I had nothing to do with any
of
this.
I told you to shut up!
Officer, if I cooperate with you...
Look, Gert, you're going to ruin my chances.
Come on, Ritter.
Look, for the sake of the children, please.
Come on, Ritter.
All of a sudden, it's for the children. Officer, how bad do you want that guy in the mugshot you showed Artie?
Bad enough. We'll get him and his partner.
Well, it better be today. I heard him tell Artie they've got another big score set for tonight.
Where?
He didn't say. But suppose I told you where they'll be later this afternoon.
Well, I don't have the authority to promise you a deal. All I could do is tell the district attorney you've been cooperative. You have a police record?
Just a couple of traffic tickets until now.
Well, I can't guarantee anything.
I don't have much choice, do I? If I go to prison, my kids will have to stay with Artie's mother. That shouldn't happen to a dog. Would I be able to call someone to pick the kids up after school?
As soon as we get to the station.
Thank you. Okay, here goes. They'll be playing high-stakes poker in the East Side pool room. It's in an alley just off of Glen, next to Ziggy's Bar. And the game starts at 4 sharp.
How do you know that?
Well, I heard Artie trying to fix it with him to get him in the game. He said they had a lot of cash. A fella named Phil Marcy runs the game. Artie gets a cut out of the suckers he sends.
How much are they paying you? Nothing.
Our family operates like a mofessel.
What's that?
Hindustani for a kibbutz.
A what?
A commune. You have to work to eat.
Man, that's terrible. Even the little kids?
Bob, look how much we collected for the library fund. And we're only just starting. Everybody has empty bottles. Now, we have to separate the colored ones from the clear ones. Come on.
You see? The whole family works.
Doesn't look like there's any poker game in there. So close up.
Well, I wasn't all that anxious to walk into a shootout anyway. But why would she want to put us on?
Let's check the alleyway. What gets me is she was so positive.
A bum steer wouldn't help her case.
Staring right at us.
Somebody is inside.
There's got to be a connecting door through the bar.
Let's call for a couple of units and hit them.
How about a lemonade break?
Great.
You gonna have time for a haircut today?
Today?
Mm.
I just got one last week.
I know, but it doesn't show. Your dad mentioned it last night.
What does he want, a flat top? This is modern times. Oh, no. Oh, no. Ryan?
Mom, how many new library books will these buy?
Ryan, you can't bring these bottles in here.
We have to separate them, Mom. Then we'll take them out and put them in our car.
Don't you dare. Pete, Whitney, now all of you take your share of these cartons and take them out to your own garages.
Their moms won't let them, Mom. I told them you'd drive us to the Cashin Depot in Van Nuys.
But that's absolutely impossible. Now all of you take the bottles and go home.
Gosh, Mom, I promised.
Well, you shouldn't have.
You said it was a worthwhile project for my generation. Please, Mom. It only stays open till 5 o'clock.
Okay. Okay. Bob, stay by the phone in case your dad calls.
Why would he call?
Oh, I don't know. He just might.
Are you worried about something, Mom?
No. Nothing special.
Stay put till you hear from us.
Ray, check your CC unit.
Okay, Greg.
Loud and clear.
Marcy.
Never heard of him.
Don't touch that signal. Police officer. Sergeant Martin.
What is this? I run a strictly straight business.
Well, then you got no problem. Put your hands on the bar. Lean on him.
Who are you, mister?
Joe Gorman, from the gas station down the street. Identification in my wallet.
It's all right, Mr. Gorman. We'll try not to keep you too long. Ziggy, around here beside him.
You'll hear about this from downtown.
Maybe. Ray, there ought to be a wire running from somewhere near the cash register in the back room. Ziggy was trying to signal.
Yeah, here it is. Wire runs under a door back there, and it's locked.
Yeah, let me have the unit. W2 to W6.
Go ahead, Chad.
We've located the way in. You and Ferris take the car around the front.
Two men with tear gas and a bullhorn join us in the bar. Send the unit around to cover the rear from the alley. You want to tell us how many in the game back there?
How would I know? Just some friends playing cards.
Yeah, two of them are armed stick-up men.
Arm? Well, Phil sure don't know anything about that.
No, he just knows he got money.
Well, look, Sergeant, I might as well tell you now. There's five players back there, counting Phil.
One of them's Charlie Pasmanic. Know him? Big blonde guy, scar across here?
Oh, yeah, yeah. He's back there. He came in with a young guy, called him Gus.
Long hair, sideburns?
Yeah, stinks of cologne.
Where's the poker table, front or back?
Right in the middle, by where that booth is.
Sergeant, we're all set outside.
Take these two men outside in case there's any shooting.
Your king bets, Gus.
Look at the size of the pot. 70 skins.
Marcy, this is Sergeant Chad Smith, Police Department. I'm ordering all persons in the pool room to come out through the bar with their hands up. This place is surrounded.
Let's go. You heard the band, gentlemen.
What are you, some kind of a nut?
Shut up, you punk.
What's with a gun? It's just a poker game.
Pasmanic, this is Sergeant Smith. We know you and Gus are in there.
Okay, you guys, on the floor. Quiet. Come on. All of you, face down.
Charlie, you better come out now.
Skylar, get the...
the canister.
Shoot.
All right, take him in.
That was a close one.
I hope Betty doesn't see it in the papers. Another shootout, it'll be all she needs. Well, 20 to 5, at least the stores are still open.
Store's still open?
I got a little shopping to do.
He wears a suit and tie and has short hair. Strictly establishment. I'm sure Dad'd like him.
Well, the question is, do you like him?
No.
Why not? Because he's not an oddball?
Not an oddball? In that outfit, he's just plain weird.
Do you think your dad is weird?
Of course not, but Dad belongs to a different age. Albert is now.
Where'd you meet Albert?
He's Tammy's brother. She never mentioned him, but there he was in the library, so she had to introduce him. He wanted to carry my books.
Is that so bad?
Why should he want to carry my books? I wouldn't carry his.
I wish your dad would come home.
Mom, you've been uptight all day. Why?
Oh, nothing special. Are you going to see Albert again?
Only from a distance. Hi, Dad.
Pot roast. Hi.
I hope it's not too dried out.
Hi, hon. I'm sorry. I'm late. Hi.
I just got home myself. Cindy fixed dinner.
Hi, Dad.
Hi.
You're late.
I know. When are you going to get a haircut?
I practically just got one.
Whatever happened to the good old Butch I used to hate?
Oh, hi, Dad. I collected almost $4 for the library, and I cleaned up the neighborhood. Tomorrow we start on newspapers.
Oh, no, not another newspaper drive.
Dad, we have to clean up what they call ecology.
It's a worthwhile project, and I approve of it.
Now, that's what I said. And the next thing, I was driving his ecology army in 627 empty bottles all the way out to Van Nuys. And how was your day?
Nothing special. A couple of routine reports. Oh, remember to get my new blue tie.
Hey, you remember?
Yeah, naturally.
Gee, I thought you'd get so involved that you would forget. Oh, it's beautiful, Chad. Navy blue.
I tell you, shopping those crowded stores is murder. It's worth your life. But there it is, navy blue.